2016 could be a record year for firearm sales. The FBI is expected to conduct more than 23 million background checks on potential gun buyers.
Now there's new evidence that a growing number of minorities are looking to buy firearms for the first time. 7 News reporter Dave Jordan has the story.
Yeah, the stock comes out.
Paul Oliver, the owner of Oliver Arms in Spartanburg, is having a very good year. Business is up and customers are happy.
We prefer it just to be more of a normal, steady pattern of sales, and that's basically what we've been experiencing before and after the election.
Oliver saw a slight bounce in sales after the November election. He also saw his minority clientele increase, and several of those customers signed up for his concealed weapons permit classes.
I would say a fairly consistent growth pattern of some of the minorities in our CWP classes. It has not been anything dramatic either way, but we've seen a steady growth.
But for the Atlanta-based National African American Gun Association, the interest has been overwhelming. President Philip Smith started this group in February 2015 and now has more than 14,000 members across the country. A surge of new members joined over Thanksgiving weekend.
We saw 1,000 members join our organization in just 4 days. And for us, those are big numbers. For some other organizations, it's not very much, but for us, that says something is going on.
Smith believes that something is Donald Trump. In the days following his election, the Southern Poverty Law Center says more than 700 incidents of harassment, intimidation, and violence against minorities were reported. Some of those assailants even invoked Trump's name as the attacks were being committed.
That combined with the emails and the phone calls that I have gotten literally 24/7 since Trump's election lets me know that there is a climate, real or perceived, that is prevalent out there, that some people are saying, you know what, I'm just not feeling safe.
There is little data showing a racial breakdown on gun ownership, but according to the Pew Research Center, 41% of American whites own a firearm. Only 19% of blacks do. Sales of guns across the board have increased steadily since 2003. Smith says his focus is on responsible gun ownership and advocacy. His organization already has 13 chapters in several cities and is poised for further growth.
Well, I see it's having literally 5 or 6 chapters in every state. I see us having a very active membership, having a political arm as well.
Here at home, Oliver says he's pleased to see more non-traditional gun owners.
Our programs are reaching out to more and more groups. I guess that would probably be the way that I view it. They see news reports about more crimes happening, and they want to have the option of self-preservation and protecting themselves and loved ones.
A step many believe is necessary in this day and age and could mean the difference between life and death. In Spartanburg, Dave Jordan, 7 News.
Al Smith says he has received support from several NRA members.
Earlier this year, he was even featured on the NRA's website.